Shalom. I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and elders, great millstone, and salutation to the elect scattered abroad. All right, my name is Amon Gabar, back with another lesson, Lord willing, to edify and to feed the lambs of Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, through the Holy Spirit, Rakak Wadash. All right, as you see in the title, will Yahweh Shai come back in the year 2019? Or will Yahweh Shai come back next year? Because we're in the year 2018. Presently, October the 23rd. All right. So, will Yahweh Shai come back next year, 2019? I don't know. You don't know. Yahweh Shai himself don't even know. All right. Because you know you got what's going around. You know, Israelites out there who think that Yahweh Shai is coming back in the year 2019, marking 400 years since we've been in captivity here in America. Alright, going back to 1619, alright, when, you know, it was reported that the first, you know, so-called Negro slaves came over here to serve in America, alright, but that's not the case, alright, that's not the case at all. For many reasons, that's not the case, because first of all, let me go to the book of Genesis, chapter 15, verse 13, where the prophecy was spoken. It says, "And he said unto Abraham, Know of a surety, that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years." Now, Israelites, you know, read this scripture and think that it's talking about America, right? They think it's talking about America simply because, you know, we've been here for almost 400 years, for damn near 400 years, right? You know, and that we've been afflicted in America for 400 years, and also there's numerous scriptures that compare Egypt to America, but this is not talking about America, all right? This is talking about ancient Egypt. This prophecy was pertaining to ancient Egypt. Let's read it one more time. It says, "And he," Genesis 15, 13, "And he said unto Abram, Know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years, and also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge, and afterwards shall they come out with great substance." Alright, because at the end of it all, what happened in ancient Egypt? Yahweh Shai judged ancient Egypt, man. Alright, and there's more scriptures that I'm going to bring out to prove that it is not talking about America, right? This is talking about ancient Egypt. Now, this is when the prophecy came to pass, Exodus 12 and 40. "Now the sojourning of the children of Israel who dwelt in Egypt was 430 years. Why 430 years? Because remember, the 30 years, Joseph went into Egypt, all right? The children of Israel was already in Egypt, all right? But the bulk of the children of Israel were in Egypt at the 400 years, man. For 400 years straight up, okay? So that's talking about Israelites dwelling in Israel, dwelling in Egypt at that time. It says, "And it shall come to pass," "and it came to pass at the end of the 430 years, even the selfsame day, it came to pass that all the hosts of the Lord went out of the land of Egypt." All right, because, matter of fact, the scriptures tell you that 70 souls went into the land of Egypt, all right? 70 souls went into the land of Egypt, you know? So, now I'm going to jump to the book of Matthew, chapter 24. It says, "Immediately after the tribulation of those days, shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heaven shall be shaken. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory." Alright? Power and great glory. That's talking about when Yahweh Shai comes back. And the great glory and the power is talking about when he comes with the angels and the chariots. It says, "And he shall send his angel with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of the heaven to the other. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, ye know that the summer is nigh. So likewise, when ye shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors." Alright? Now the parable of the fig tree is talking about is in comparison to the prophecies. Okay, it's comparable to the prophecies, all right? When the prophecies a blooming, all right, that's when you know that summer is nigh. Summer represents the Lord coming back. All right. It says, so likewise ye, when ye shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. Verily I say.